Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining again today. We've got another prop modding video for you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm pretty excited about today's cosplay prop video. I am doing Los Angeles Comic-Con 2024 in about 2 weeks here, and for it I'm going to be doing a Gambit cosplay. And that Gambit cosplay is going to be comprised of about 70% MCU, about 20% animated series, and about 10% comic books. So for that, I wanted to make a unique cosplay of Gambit. I've seen a lot of people do it before. I've never seen anybody do what I did for the cards. Obviously, he has both a charged staff, chargeable staff, and a chargeable deck of cards as his main weapon. So I couldn't possibly do the cosplay without having the cards. I used a deck of Bicycle gold foil cards. They are very nice. I actually hated cutting them up, but they look absolutely amazing. So let me go ahead and turn them on here. They are each individually hooked up to two separate lighting circuits, one on the outside edge and one that faces the interior so that you can see the symbols lit up on each card. Let's get a good look up close. Let's go ahead and turn off these lights to get the full effect. Oh my gosh, they're just absolutely amazing. I could not have possibly had these turn out better than they do. And they're gonna smoke at the convention. So now, without further ado, you get to watch me build them. The first thing that we're doing here is we're using a Sharpie marker to blacken the edges of the cards, as these cards have gold edges and Gambit's MCU cards have black edges. They are not by any means the same cards, but they do have a similar paisley pattern on them, which is why I chose Bicycle's gold deck. We're using 6 cards for this project, 2 cards for each prop card, a number card on the front, and a blank card for the back. The second thing we're doing is using an X-Acto knife to cut out just the symbols on the number cards. Now, we're using a 300mm Adafruit Nudes flexible 3-volt COB lighting strip encased in silicone to make the edge of the card prop. These things are absolutely awesome because they are bright as hell and can be powered for hours off a single 2032 coin cell battery. Next, we're using parchment paper to cover the cutout symbol holes on the number cards from the backside. This will help diffuse the light inside of the cards. At this point, it's time to install a pink set of 6-volt fairy lights around the inside of the Adafruit Nudes lighting strip on the edge of the card. This will provide lighting on the inside of the card. It'll light up the cutout symbols covered in parchment paper, but not the rest of the face of the card. Now, we're super gluing the number card onto the previously prepared back card.
Next up, we're soldering the 2032 coin cell battery holder and leads to the anode and cathode ends of the Adafruit Nudes lighting strip. Now, I'm closing off the connections by heating the wire wraps. Finally, I'm using hot glue to fill the edges of the cards above the Adafruit Nudes lighting strip, extending the pink edge lighting out just beyond the edge of the card.
And here is the finished ace card. It's absolutely amazing. I love it. Let's go ahead and turn the lights off so you get the real full effect. Looks amazing. And what's better than one of these? How about three of them, all finished, since basically for the second and third one, I just repeated the exact same process that you just watched. Yeah, these turned out absolutely amazing. I am super, super happy. Each is hooked up to two circuits, one circuit for the outside noodle from Adafruit and the other for the just cheap old fairy lights inside facing inwards. Each runs on one 3-volt coin cell battery or two 6-volt coin cell batteries. Absolutely awesome, super simple, super practical, can be hidden up my sleeve while I hold it in my hand, and then if I need to put them down, can just pull them out and set them down. Now we are going to move on to the smoke machine.
I'm using a Castronica smoke machine by Wayne's Workshop, an excellent smoke machine with a variable speed knob. We're going to both run hosing and a 6-volt bright pink LED up the arm of the glove and into the palm, where they will both be mounted. Now I'm mounting the pink light in the palm with hot glue and a small section of webbing. Next, it's time to test the smoke machine and lighting.
Yeah, that's gonna be rad. All right, man. Well, the smoke machine is just that simple. So it's time to put the glove on and hold the cards up and see what it looks like.
And now it's time to test the smoke machine wearing the glove. And now, the final costumed look. If you enjoyed this video, please let me know I am doing a good job by giving it a thumbs up and commenting. And if you wish to support me further as a creator, please subscribe and tap that bell to all notifications so that you never miss any future content from my channel. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.